Good evening, Travers.
Good evening, Camille. It's a situation that many inside this New Orleans-based police nonprofit were unaware of, but one they vowed to address. We wanted to know how a man with a lengthy rap sheet held a position helping raising money for cops in New Orleans. Inside the New Orleans Police Department, every dollar counts. It's no secret the embattled department is cash-strapped. In fact, Mayor Mitch Landrieu is on record saying new federal mandates with a $50 million price tag could cripple the department. And while the bulk of NOPD's funding comes from the city, private donations also go a long way. More than 15 years ago, the nonprofit New Orleans Police and Justice Foundation was created to raise money for the New Orleans Police Department. The group has essentially become the fundraising arm of the NOPD, bringing in millions of dollars since its inception.
No, it doesn't make it any better.
Former Orleans Parish Prosecutor Melanie Talia serves as executive director.
We have a board of religious, civic, and community and business leaders.
The board is a who's who of prominent New Orleanians. That includes former FBI Director James Bernazani, former Homeland Security Chief Terry Ebert, musician Irvin Mayfield, and Downtown Development Director Kurt Weigel. Central City Reverend John Pierre is also a board member. His name is listed on the foundation's official rolls. Reverend Pierre runs the Living Witness Church of God in Central City and has been on the Police and Justice Foundation board since 2008. The license plate on his car hints at his involvement. But while Reverend Pierre has spent the last 5 years on a board raising funds for cops, he's recently had his own problems with police.
Well, a pastor trusted by his flock is accused of spending their money fraudulently. Pastor John Pierre of the Living Witness Church of God is accused of wasting $160,000.
In 2011, the Louisiana Inspector General accused Pierre of improperly using $250,000 he received in Katrina-related recovery money from the state. The funds were meant to help build a facility for recovering addicts near Pierre's church. This is what's there now, just a blighted building. The IG says Pierre instead put some of the money to personal use. So the case was referred to the East Baton Rouge District Attorney's Office. Prosecutors in that parish tell the WDSUI team that they're in the final stages of a plea deal with Pierre, but there's a holdup. Prosecutors say public records show that in 1969, Pierre was arrested in New Orleans and convicted of armed robbery. State records show it wasn't the only legal problem for Pierre. In 1977, prosecutors say Pierre was again arrested and convicted in New Orleans of burglary. Prosecutors told the I-team that Pierre's rap sheet, while old, shows more than a half dozen other arrests. And they say that criminal history will play a role in how things unfold in this most recent case.
We will continue in the work that we've done.
The New Orleans Police and Justice Foundation was unaware of Pierre's past until we brought it to their attention.
Yes, I was quite surprised to learn that.
So the looming question, how did a man with a history of arrest and felony convictions, who's currently facing a new criminal prosecution, get appointed to a board that raises money for the state's largest police department?
When Reverend Pierre was invited to join the board, it was in conjunction with the police department program to rally the clergy to help us get the youth and help us stop the violence.
Talia admits Pierre's background never came up when he was appointed.
I think most boards made up of civic and business community leaders like ours are not customarily conducting background investigations. And you would hope that any member, any person of the in the community invited to be a board member would be forthcoming with those sorts of things.
He should have disclosed. He should have said, I would love to serve on the board. You need to know this is what has happened to me in the past.
We have repeatedly attempted to call and reach John Pierre. His wife told us he did not want to talk about the situation.
You wouldn't put a fox over a hen house. And so I think you need to know something about people's background.
And while John Pierre is not talking to us, he did reach out to the Police and Justice Foundation.
In light of the story, a board member has spoken to Mr. Pierre and his resignation is forthcoming.
Melanie Talia says she did receive Reverend Pierre's resignation today after our inquiries. She does not believe this situation will affect the mission of her group. Norman.
All right, Travis, the story doesn't end there. An attorney representing John Pierre on the latest charges refused to comment on the situation. He would only confirm that talks with prosecutors in East Baton Rouge Parish are ongoing.